and the line of Cadmus nursed at his ancient hearth. Why have you strewn yourselves before these altars in supplication with your vows and garlands? The breath of incense rises from the city with the sound of prayer and lamentation. Children, I would not have you speak through messengers, and therefore I have come to hear you myself. I, Oedipus, who bear a famous name. You then, speak for them all. Tell me with praise upon you, whether you come in dread or crave some blessing, tell me, and never doubt that I will help you in every way I can. I would be heartless were I not moved to find you suppliant here.
Come, my children. It was for this we came. And now the king has promised it himself. Apollo has sent us an order. May he descend himself to save us and drive out the flame.
Follow, go in at the far. dreams leap against the fires of our grief, the fires of darkness. Be swift to bring us rest. As in the old time, through the brilliant house of air, you stepped to save us. Come again.
Now our afflictions have no end. Now all of our stricken host lies down, and no man fights off death with his mind. The noble plowland bears no grain, and groaning mothers cannot bear. See how our lives like birds take wing, like sparks that fly when a fire soars to the shore of the god of evening. The plague burns on. It is pitiless. No pallid children laden with death lie unwept in stony ways, and old gray women by every path flock to the strand about the altars, there to strike their breast and cry, worship of all the wailing prayers, be by God's golden child.
There are no swords in this attack by fire, no shields but bear ring with the cries. Send the besieger plunging from our homes into the vast sea river of the Atlantic.
For the day ravages what the night spares.
Destroy our enemy, Lord of the Thunder! Let him be rended by lightning from heaven!
Apollo, stretch that other bowstring, that golden cord until it sing for us, flashing arrows in heaven.
Artemis, Huntress! Race with flaring lights upon our mountains.
O scarlet god, O golden banded brow, O demon thy host and sword of maniacs, whirl upon them and hold the undying gate, come with blinding torches, come in joy.
Is this your prayer? Forbid the people of this country, where power and throne are mine, ever to receive that man, or to speak to him, no matter who he is, or let him join in sacrifice, lustration, or in prayer. I decree that he be driven from every house, being as he is, corruption itself to us. The Delphic voice of Zeus has pronounced this revelation. As for the criminal, I pray whether he be a lurking thief or one of a number, I pray that man's life be consumed in evil and wretchedness. And as for me, this curse applies no less. If it should turn out that the culprit is here, a guest sharing my heart, you have heard the penalty. I lay this on you now to attend to, for my sake. For Apollo's, for the sick, sterile city that heaven has abandoned. Suppose the oracle gave you no command. Should this defilement go uncleansed forever? Your king, a noble king, have been destroyed. Now I, having the power he held for me, having his bed, begetting children there, upon his wife, as he would have had he lived. Their son would have been my children's brother, if lies had had love in fatherhood. I say, I take the son's part, as though I were his son, and press the fight for him, and see it won. I'll find the hand that brought death to Lampicos and Polydorus' child, heir to Capos and Agenor's line. And for all those who failed him, may the gods deny them the fruit of the earth, fruit of the womb, and may they rot utterly. Let them be wretched, as we are wretched, and worse!
Mm-hmm.
Theseus! Seer! Student of mysteries, of all that is taught, and all that no man tells, secrets of heaven, and secrets of the earth. Blind though you are, you know the city lies sick with plague. And from this plague, my lord, we find that you, and you alone, can guard or save us.
Listen to me. You mock my blindness to you, but I say that you, with both your eyes, are blind. You cannot see the wretchedness of your life, nor in whose house you live, nor with whom. Who are your father and mother? Can you tell me? You do not even know the blind wrongs you have done them, on earth and in the world below. But the double lash of your parents' curse will whip you out of this land someday. The only night upon your precious eyes. Be angry then. Curse Creon, curse my words. I tell you, no man that walks upon the earth shall be rooted out more horribly than you. A blind man who has his eyes now. A penniless man who is rich now. He will go tapping the strange earth with his staff. To the children with whom he lives now, he will be brother and father, the very same. To her who bore him, son and husband, the very same. Who came to his father's bed, wet with his father's blood. Enough! Go think that over. If later you find error in what I have said, then you may say I have no skill in prophecy.
The Delphic Stone of Prophecy remembers ancient regicide and a still bloody hand.
That killer's hour of light has come. He must be stronger than rival forces of a tiring wind. For the son of Zeus, armed with his father's thunder, leaps in lightning after him, and the furies follow, the sad heroes.
Holy Parnassus,
he must know.
Lashes and blinds that secret man, that all shall hunt him down. Though he may roam the forest shade like a bull wild with passion, to rage from glooms of stone.
Doom comes down on him,
blind to the mouth of alien. For the world's heart calls him desolate, and the immortal furies fall forever come.
But now,
a wilder thing is heard from the old man's skill that's here in fate in the wing beats of a bird. Bewildered as a blown bird, my soul hovers and cannot find foothold in this debate, or any reason or rest of mind.
But no man ever brought, none can bring, proof of strife between Thebes' royal house, Lactical's line, and the son of Apollos.
And never until now has any man brought word of life's dark death,
did you not hear him say I was the one who seduced the old prophets into lying?
The thing was said. I did not know how seriously.
But you were watching. Were his eyes steady? Did he look like a man in his right mind?
I do not know. I cannot judge the behavior of great men. But he is the king himself.
Lowly the paths I journey on. Let all my
levity is so.
Let each man take two earnings then,
and keep his hands from holy things,
and from blasphemy stand apart.
Else the crackling blast of heaven blows on his head and on his desperate heart.
Though fools will honor impious men, in their cities no tragic poet sees.
Shall we lose fame in Delphi's obscurities?
We who have heard the world's core discredited,
and the sacred wood of Zeus and Hellas praise no more.
These and strange prophecies must make a pattern yet to be understood.
Zeus, if indeed you are Lord of all, throned in light over night and day,
mirror this in your endless mind.
Our masters call thee Oracle, words on the wind, and the Delphic vision blind.
Their hearts no longer know Apollo, and reverence for the gods has died.
Citizens of Thebes, it has occurred to me to visit the altars of the gods. Our king is not himself. His noble soul is overwrought with fantasies of dread, else he would consider the new prophecies in the light of the old. He will listen to any voice that speaks disaster, and my advice goes for nothing. To you, then, Apollo, I turn in prayer. Receive these offerings, and grant us deliverance from defilement. Our hearts are heavy with fear when we see our leader distracted, as helpless sailors are terrified by the fusion of their helmsmen.
Friends, no doubt you can direct me. Where shall I find the house of Oedipus, or...
That is the only word I have for you now. That is the only word I can ever.
Caught you up.
Persons. Though I do not know the man, I think I see him coming. The shepherd we walked. He is old, and the men bringing him appear to be servants of my house. But you can tell me if you have ever seen him.
I know him. He was Lyre's man. You can trust him.
First, you from Corinth. Is this the shepherd we were discussing?
This is the very man.
Come here. No, look at me. You must answer everything I ask. You belong to Lyre?
Yes. Born his slave, brought up in his house.
What kind of work did you do for him?
I was a shepherd of his most of my life.
Where many did you go for pastorage?
Sometimes Catiron, sometimes the hills nearby.
Do you remember ever seeing this woman out there?
No, at least not to my recollection.
And this is not strange, my lord, but I'll refresh his memory. He must remember when we spent 3 whole seasons together, March to September, on the hills of Catiron, or thereabouts. He had 2 flocks. My husband and I had 1. Each autumn, we returned to Corinth with ours, and he drive his back to Lyre's sheepfold. Is this not true? Just as I described it.
True, yes, but it was all so long ago.
Well, then, you must remember, back in those days that you gave me a baby boy to bring up as my own.
What if I did? What are you trying to say?
King Oedipus was once that little child.
Then you hold your tongue.
No more of that. It is your tongue that needs watching, not this woman's.
My king, my master, what is it I have done wrong?
You have not answered her question about the boy.
She does not know. She's suddenly making trouble.
Come, speak plainly, or it will go hard with you.
God's name, do not torture an old man!
Come here, bind his arms behind him.
Unhappy king, what more do you wish to learn?
Did you give this woman the child she speaks of?
I did! And I would to God I had died that very day.
You will die now unless you speak the truth.
Yet if I speak the truth, I am worse.
Very well, since you insist upon delay.
No! I have told you already that I gave her the boy.
Where did you get it? From your house? From somewhere else?
Not from mine, no. A man gave him to me.
Is that man here? Do you know who slave he was?
For God's love, my king, do not ask me anymore.
You are a dead man if I have to ask again!
Then the child is the palace of Lyre's.
Slave child? Or a child of his own line?
I am on the brink of dreadful speech.
And I have dreadful hearing. Yet I must hear.
If you must be told, then. They said it was Lyre's child, but it is your wife who can tell you about that.
My wife? Did she give it to you?
My lord, she did.
Do you know why?
I was told to get rid of it.
An unspeakable mother.
There have been prophecies.
Tell me.
It was said that the boy would kill his own father.
Then why did you give this woman the child?
I pity the baby, my king. And I thought this woman would take him far away to her own country. Saved him. But for what a fate! For if you are what this woman says you are, then no man living is more wretched than Oedipus.
Ah! All right. May I look upon you for the last time? I, Oedipus, damn it, it's mine! It is management! Damn in the blood shed with his own hand!
No!
Majestic Oedipus. Thebes, most honored in this land.
But you will see. Look, the doors are opening. In a moment you will see a thing that would crush a heart of stone.
My hand, our last time, and let us weep together.
Oh, be kind, my lord, great prince, be kind. Could I but touch them, they would be mine again, as when I had eyes. Oh, God. Is that my children I hear weeping? Has Creon pitied me and sent me my daughter?
Yes, Oedipus.
Oh, may God bless you, mothers, and be a friendlier guardian to you than he has been to me. Oh, children, where are you? Come quickly to my hand. They are your brothers. Hands that brought your father's once clear eyes to this way of seeing. Oh, dearest one. I weep for you, having no strength to see you. I weep for you when I think of the bitterness that men will visit upon you all your lives. Oh, Creon, you are the only father my daughters have, since we, their parents, are both of us gone forever. They are your own blood. You will not let them fall into beggary and loneliness. You will keep them from the miseries that are mine. See? They're only children. Friendless except for you. Promise me this, great prince. And give me your hand in token of it. Oh, children. That is much I could say. If you could understand me. As it is, I only have this prayer for you. Live where you can. Be as happy as you can. Happier, please God. Thank God has made your father.
Enough. You have wept enough. Now go within.
It is hard, but I must.
Time eases all things.
But you must promise.
Say what you desire.
Send me from Thebes.
God grants that I may.
But since the god hates me.
No. He will grant your wish.
You promise?
I cannot speak beyond my knowledge.
Lead me in.
Come now, and leave your children.
No! No, do not take them from me!
Think no longer that you are in command
here. No!
But rather think how when you were, you served your own destruction.
No!
Let every man in mankind's frailty consider.
faith.